Welcome to this brief guide on boosts, favorites, and bookmarks on Mastodon. With so many people moving over to Mastodon from other services such as Twitter, the changes in ways in which we can interact with people's posts can be a little bit confusing at first. Today I'm going to hopefully expand on that for you. Here you can see a post on my profile, but this would look the same for any post that you would view in a timeline as well. And one of the things you'll notice is I've got my options in which I can interact with this post, but one of the things I don't see is numbers around analytics. And that's because this is not the primary purpose of Mastodon. I can see that at least one person has replied, but I don't see any information around the number of people who have boosted or favorited my post. If I want to though, I can click on the post in question and expand out the full threaded view, at which point I'll be able to see the full details of the post, including how it was posted, how many people boosted it, how many people liked the post, as well as if there have been any edits and the entire edit history for this post. So then the question comes down to, how do I know when to use these particular interaction methods and what are they all for? The first of which is the option to boost someone's post. This is the equivalent of a retweet on Twitter, but it allows you to expand the reach of someone else's post across your network as well as theirs. This is a great way to show someone that you agree with their post and you think that it's a good thing that people should see it. The second one is the ability to favorite someone's post. This is more of an acknowledgement. It's kind of like the equivalent of a thumbs up reaction to someone's message. It's a way of letting them know that you've seen their post and you enjoyed their post, but it's not really designed to be a bookmarking feature. The reason is that there is a dedicated bookmark option, which is a great way to save posts should you need to be able to access them later on. It's a bit different in the way of favorites. I would recommend you favorite a lot and bookmark a little. And it's super easy to find any of your bookmarked posts just using the bookmarks option in the menu of your Mastodon client. Here you can see I have all of my bookmark posts. There's only a couple of them. Unlike my favorites, which if I was to select the favorites option in my menu, you'll see I have quite a lot of different favorited posts. As I said, I recommend you favorite a lot, bookmark a little. Now heading back to the bookmarks option, if I needed to unbookmark any of these, I can easily do that just by selecting the bookmark tab option on the post in my bookmarks area, and now it's disappeared. And that is a brief guide on the different interaction methods on Mastodon, including boosting to share people's posts, favoriting to acknowledge, and bookmarking to save. I hope you found this guide super useful and it makes your Mastodon experience just that little bit easier in the future. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.